refractometer is used to measure sugar content in any type of liquid. And so we've used it to measure the sugar content in apples, in kombucha, and other juices. And we're going to show you how to do that right now. It's super simple. So this we got on Amazon for $20. They do have a range in terms of you can buy a refractometer for like $100. We found this $20 one was great, so we highly recommend it. And you'll see it has a couple different pieces. So this is the eyepiece that you'll look through. Then here is a prism inside of this. This is where you'll put the liquid. And then this is just a cap. So in order to use this, the first thing you'll want to do is just put water on it to make sure that it's calibrated. And you'll just put one or two drops on here. Cover this. You'll notice that starts kind of sealing here. And then what you'll do is you'll look through the eyepiece and you'll want to be somewhere where there's some light. So you're gonna look up towards a light source. This currently is at zero, so it is calibrated. Delicately wipe off the water and then take my liquid. So I'm going to try kombucha that I have been brewing and see how much sugar content is in it. So I'm just taking a dropper, putting about 3 drops on here, covering it, and then looking up and I can see how much sugar is in there. Let's look at one other substance. And I'm going to wipe this off with a paper towel, actually put some water on it in between substances to make sure it's fully washed, and I will check it in between the substances I'm using. I'm going to do this fruit juice. So it's a blueberry apple juice. Cover that, put it up. And I can see right now I need to get to a stronger light source so I can see it. And now I have a very clear vision, and this is at 11 Brix, which is 11% sugar, which translates to grams of sugar in 100 grams of liquid. So if it's 11 Brix or 11%, that means there's 11 grams of sugar in 100 grams of total liquid. Now we should note that this type of refractometer is a Brix one, meaning it measures sugar. There are other types that measure salt or other dissolved solids in solutions as well. And they all use the same principle, which is refraction, or the bending of light. So essentially, we have a prism inside here, and when light hits it, it bends due to a difference in medium. And what we'll notice is that depending on the amount of solids in the solution, we'll see different amounts of refraction or bending of light. If there are more solids in the solution, there will be more bending. And so that's what this is actually measuring. To learn more about the science behind this device and where to buy it, be sure to check out the links below and like and subscribe for more videos.